Hello everyone, how are you all? This is your educator G. Vijaya Manorama. Subscribe my channel Vijaya Manorama Tutorials. As a part of term 1 revision, we are discussing multiple choice questions of life processes. Okay, so two parts already finished. So after this part, I am going to give you the PDF of this complete multiple choice questions. In the description box you will find. Okay, after the class you can check. So here is the 40 questions already we have discussed in the two parts. So other some more 40 questions we are going to discuss now. 50 questions today we are going to discuss. So the processes which together perform the maintenance job are. So already I have given the answers here. You can check. You can download this and take the PDF for your practice. Okay. So life proceedings, life processes, life maintenance, none of the above. Life processes is the answer. Next, the process of acquiring oxygen from outside the body and to use it in the process of breakdown of food sources for cellular needs is called respiration, digestion, transportation, excretion. So respiration is the answer for this. Okay, next, the waste products removed from the body and discarded by the process is called respiration, digestion, transportation, excretion. Excretion is the answer. Let me take here also. Next, following are autotrophs. Green plants, some bacteria, enzymes, and both A and B. Green plants are also called as autotrophs, as we have read that statement. So few bacteria are also autotrophs. Okay. As autotrophic mode of nutrition is divided into two. Okay, in green plants and few bacteria, photosynthesis and chemosynthesis. Okay, so that example you can remind here. Following is true for heterotrophs. Heterotroph survival depends upon directly or indirectly on autotrophs. Heterotrophic organisms include animals and fungi. In heterotrophs, complex substances have to be broken down into simpler ones. All of the above. So which one is autotrophs? Heterotrophs indirectly or directly depends on autotrophs. It is also include animals and fungi. This also broken into simpler ones. So the answer is all of the above. Carbon and energy requirements of the autotrophic organisms are fulfilled by enzymes, photosynthesis, bacteria, none of the above. Photosynthesis is the answer. Dash are utilized for providing energy to the plant. Carbohydrates, vitamins, proteins and fats. Carbohydrates is the answer. The following events occur during photosynthesis is. During the photosynthesis, absorption of light energy by chlorophyll, conversion of light energy to chemical energy and reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrates. All the processes takes place during photosynthesis. That's why it is all of the above. Next one, chlorophyll is contained in leaf, stem, roots, both A and B. It is leaf and stem, both it contains. See, such easy questions only most of the children, they get confused and they do mistake. If chlorophyll is contained in, if you see leaf, if anyone will take, it will say wrong answer. So it is leaf and stem also contain chlorophyll. Next, tiny pores present on the surface of the leaves are known as small tiny pores. They are called as stomata. Chloroplast organelles, none of them were wrong answers. Stomata is the right answer. Then following used in photosynthesis is taken up from the soil by the roots in terrestrial plants. Water it is, terrestrial plants. So take up from the soil, it is water. Nitrogen, magnesium, all the above are the wrong answers. Examples of some organisms which break down the food materials outside the body and then absorb it. Okay, they are fungi, yeast, mushrooms. These all comes under this only. They are the examples of the organisms which break down the food material outside the body and absorb it. Okay, next, some organism which derive nutrition from plants or animals without killing them. It is also all of the above. Cascuta, ticks, leeches, everything comes under that. Next one, dash takes in food using temporary finger-like extensions of the cell surface. Amoeba, green plants, tapeworms, none of the above. Amoeba, it extends like this structure around the food material to trap it. Okay, so they are called as pseudopodia. The dash is basically a long tube extended from the mouth to the anus. So complete that, which is a long tube which is involved from mouth to anus, that is called as alimentary canal. Esophagus, diaphragm, bile duct. So esophagus is the tube from food pipe to stomach. Diaphragm is the layer which separates the abdominal cavity and thoracic cavity. Bile duct is the duct, okay, which produces bile juice, which releases, produces. So gastric glands release dash a protein digesting enzyme called pepsin and mucus release hydrochloric acid. Okay, sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, none of the above. Hydrochloric acid is the answer. Following are having shorter small intestine. Shorter small intestine is present in carnivores. Okay, the enzymes present in secrete intestinal juice finally convert the proteins to amino acids, complex carbohydrates to glucose, fats to fatty acids and glycerol. It is all the above. The inner lining of the small intestine has numerous finger-like projections called. Okay, this is imagine this is the small intestine where you will find so many finger-like projection which increases the absorption rate are called as villi. Okay, so glucose is a dash carbon molecule, six carbon molecule, C6H12O6. Okay, pyruvate is a dash carbon molecule, it is 5. Okay, the process of breaking molecules in the absence of oxygen is called, in the absence of oxygen it is anaerobic respiration, in the presence of oxygen it is aerobic respiration. So anaerobic respiration, absence of oxygen. Lactic acid is a dash carbon molecule, it is a 5 carbon molecule. Okay, so breaking down of glucose in the presence of oxygen produces carbon dioxide, water and energy, all. The energy released during the process of respiration is used to make an dash molecule, ATP molecules, adenosine triphosphate molecules. ATP can be used in the cells for the dash, contraction of muscles, protein synthesis, conduction of nervous impulses, all of the above. It is all of the above. Okay, following is true about lungs. Within the lungs, the passage divides into smaller and smaller tubes. The lungs always contain a residual volume of air so that there is insufficient time for oxygen to be absorbed. Both are true about the lungs. In human beings, the respiratory pigment is hemoglobin, is the respiratory pigment. Insulin, enzyme, none of the above. These all things are wrong. Hemoglobin is present in RBCs, red blood corpuscles. Plasma transport dash in dissolved form. Food, carbon dioxide, nitrogen is waste. All of the above it is. Okay, following has to be transported by the blood. Oxygen and carbon dioxide both can be transported by the blood only. Impurities in the form of carbon dioxide and pure oxygen, which is carried to each and every cell, then only our cells are working, we are working. Next, following is or are true about heart. Everything. Oxygen-rich blood from the lungs comes to the left atrium. Deoxygenated blood comes from the body of the upper chamber on the right atrium as it relaxes. Valves ensure that blood does not flow backwards when the atria or ventricles contract. All of the above is the right answer. Amphibians or many reptiles have dash-chambered heart. It is three-chambered heart. The normal systolic pressure is about dash mm of mercury and diastolic pressure is dash mm of mercury. It is a normal blood pressure that is 120 by 80. Okay, it is written as 120 by 80. Mm of Hg, it is shown in the BP machine. So that, what is that machine called as? Next question. Blood pressure is measured with an instrument called manometer, sphygmomanometer, hydrometer, anemometer. It is sphygmomanometer. BP machine is called as sphygmomanometer. Do remember, kids? Dash are the vessels which carry blood away from the heart to various organs of the body. It is arteries. Following is true for tissues, fluid or lymph. It is colorless. It is similar to plasma of the blood as it contains proteins. All of the above is the right answer. Following is true for plants. Plants have low energy needs. The xylem moves water and minerals obtained from the soil. Phloem transport the products of the photosynthesis from the leaves to other parts of the plant. That is the food material which it carries. So all of the above is the right answer. The loss of water in the form of vapor from the aerial parts of the plant is known as transpiration. Okay, loss of water is called as transpiration. Next, the transport of soluble products of photosynthesis is called translocation, means food material which is prepared, no, during the photosynthesis, that is carried to each and every part of the plant. Translocation. Next one, the excretory system of human beings includes a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, urinary bladder and a urethra, all of the above. These all are the parts of excretory system. Which one is true? Carbon dioxide is removed from the blood in the lungs. Yes. Nitrogenous waste such as urea or uric acid is removed from the blood in the kidneys. Yes. The purpose of making urine is to filter out waste products from the blood is all of the above. Yes. Next, the kidney is associated with the cup-shaped end of the coiled tube which is called as Bowman's capsule. Cup-shaped. You will find it like this. Okay, Bowman's capsule it is. Next, each kidney has large number of filtration units called as nephrons. Okay, functional and filtration unit of kidneys are nephrons. Glomerulus, renal vein, none of the above, it is wrong. Nephrons is the right answer. Which of the following is an example of anabolic process? It is photosynthesis. Digestion in extracellular is all of the above. In all extracellular only, animals, human, amoeba, everything. In order for the blood to flow from right ventricle to left ventricle in mammalian heart, it must flow through right ventricle to pulmonary arteries, from there to lungs, from there to pulmonary veins, from there to left atrium. Okay. So what is the end product of fat digestion? It is fatty acids and glycerol. Okay. End product of fats when it is digested, it converts in the form of fatty acids and glycerol. So both A and B are the right answers. Next, conversion of large fat droplets into smaller droplets are called as emulsification. That is only called as emulsification of food. Okay, next, alternate contraction and relaxation of the alimentary canal is called peristalsis. Okay, the wavy movement which you find during the swallowing of the food. Okay, so alternate contraction and relaxation of alimentary canal is called as peristalsis. Okay, so these are 90 questions whose PDF also you will find in the description box. So take care of yourself, subscribe my channel, share with your friends, be prepared for your term 1 examination. If you have any queries, ask in the comment section or ask in the Telegram channel. So Telegram group link is given in the it is provided in the description box. You can join me through that to my group. Any queries related to 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 11th and 12th bio, 9th and 10th science, physics, chemistry, bio, anything you can ask. Okay, So 11th and 12th also physics chemistry you just ask, no problem. But I am going to teach 11th and 12th bio in this channel. Okay. So thank you. Bye bye. Take care. Join my group. Be safe. Be strong. Be confident. All the best, my dear students. Bye bye. Take care.